Hi all. In this video, we are discussing plus one improvement chemistry questions July 2019. First question. Which of the following contains maximum number of molecules? There are four options: 1 gram of N2, 1 gram of CO2, 1 gram of H2 and 1 gram of NH3. We know that the molecule with the low molecular weight will contain maximum number of molecules. So the answer is hydrogen. That is 1 gram hydrogen. Question number 2. Represent the orbital with the quantum numbers N is equal to 5 and L is equal to 3. N is the principal quantum number and L is the azimuthal quantum number. N gives the main shell. So it is the shell number is 5 and L gives the subshell. It's starting from S, P, T. So if it is 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So it is F. 5F. Answer is 5F. Which property of liquids is associated with the fire polishing of glass? We know that when the glasses are cut, the end will be sharp. On heating, it will become melt and acquire smooth surface. This is due to the property of surface tension. So the answer is surface tension. Question number 4. In a process, 701 joule of heat is absorbed by a system and 394 joule of work is done by the system. Calculate the change in internal energy. So we know that the change in internal energy delta U is equal to Q plus W. So here heat is absorbed by the system, the sign of Q is positive and work is done by the system. If a system is doing work by itself, the sign of work will be negative. So, answer is 307 joule. Question number 5. Name the compound used in Clark's method for the removal of hardness of water. Answer is calcium hydroxide. Question number 6. The alkali metal which has the highest reducing power. So, in aqueous medium, we know that lithium has highest reducing power. We know the reason, because of high hydration enthalpy of lithium, because of high charge density. Question number 7. Name any one method used for the estimation of nitrogen in an organic compound. You can write either Dumas method or Gerdas method. Question number 8. Real gases do not obey ideal gas equation under all conditions. Explain. Real gases will obey ideal gas equations at higher temperature and low pressures, because at this condition it will obey all the postulates of kinetic molecular theory. But when the temperature will be low and pressure increases, what happens? We know that the total volume is a constant. So when high pressure increases, the volume of each molecule is not negligible. So it does not obey the kinetic theory postulate. The volume of each molecule is negligible. And one more thing, when the temperature is low, it won't get the enough energy to break the interaction between them. So there is intermolecular force existing between the molecule. As a result, it affects the pressure of this gas. Question number 9. Give the IUPAC name of the element with atomic number 117. We know that according to the IUPAC convention, initially we named it as anon septium un for 1 and septium sept for 7, but now it is represented as TS and the name is Tennessee. In the modern periodic table, elements in a given group have similar chemical properties, and the reason for that is we know that the main reason is electronic configuration, but there is variation of strength of properties in group when we moving down. That is due to the increasing atomic size and ionization enthalpy, decrease of ionization enthalpy, etc. Question number 10. Name the colorless toxic gas that is produced when BF3 is heated with sodium hydroxide. It is when it is striped, the sodium doesn't came, sorry. Draw its structure. We know that when BF3 react with the sodium hydride, the major product will be diborane. And diborane has a special structure of 3-centered 2-electron bond called banana bond. Because of that structure, it is highly unstable and it will easily catch as fire. Question number 11. Identify A and B in the following reaction. So phenol is given. When it is reacted with zinc, we will get A. And when it is reacted with methyl chloride and aluminium chloride, that is Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, we'll get B. So here zinc will remove oxygen, that is zinc oxide will remove, and we'll get benzene, that is the first product A. And when it is benzene on reaction with methyl chloride in presence of aluminium chloride, we'll get methyl benzene. Its common name is toluene. So the second product is, we can write either methyl benzene, that's IUPAC name of toluene, or you can write toluene itself, or you can write the structure. Question number 12. For the equilibrium 2NOCl giving 2NO plus Cl2, the value of equilibrium constant of the reaction at the same temperature is, that is Kp is given, Kp is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 2 at 500 Kelvin. Calculate the Kc. So we know the relation between Kp and Kc for gaseous reactants and product. Kp is equal to Kc into RT raised to delta N, where delta N is the change in number of molecules. That is number of molecules, number of gaseous molecules in products minus number of gaseous molecules in reactants. Here there are 2NO plus 1Cl2. There are 3 molecules in product side and two molecule of NOCl in reactant side. So delta N value 3 minus 2, that is only 1. So we can substitute the values 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by 500 into, I substitute the value of 0.0, value of R is 0.083. Raised to 1, so that will be the same, and we'll get the answer 0.0433 into 10 raised to minus 2. You can check the calculation once again. Sometimes there may be mistakes in typing error or something like that. So excuses about that. Question number 13. Dipole moment of BeF2 is 0, while that of H2O is 1.85 d. That is a positive dipole moment. Account for this on the basis of their structure. We know that both BeF2 and H2, both are polar molecules. They are polar molecules because of their electron negativity difference between the atoms connected in covalent bonds. But one of them has zero dipole moment and other one has negative dipole moment. Reason: in BeF2, look at the structure of BeF2. It is linear structure. That is, dipole moment towards one side is just cancelled by the other side because both having same value. So its dipole moment, even though it is polar, its dipole moment is zero. But when we come to water, it also has two polar bonds, but both the dipole moment goes in one direction. So the resultant dipole moment will be positive because of its bent or V-shaped structure. Question number 14. An alkene on osmolysis give two molecules of ethanol. Identify the alkene. Draw its isomeric forms. So we know that osmolysis is the breaking of alkenes with oxygen. See, since we get two identical molecules, the alkene will be symmetrical. So we got two ethanol, so there will be four carbon atoms. So symmetrical alkene with four carbon atom, it's only the possible structure is 2-butene. So 2-butene we can draw two geometrical isomers, that is cis-2-butene and trans-2-butene. The structure is given. The 2-butene, there is one E at the end. So this is cis-butene. Both the CH3 are on the same side, it is called a cis molecule. And if the same molecules are on different side of the double bond plane, it is called a trans-2-butene. Question number 15. A molecule of the type AB4E has four bond pairs of electron and one bond pair of electron. Predict the most stable structure of this compound. So we know that it has total five bond pairs. If there is five bond pairs, the expected shape is trigonal bipyramidal, but one of these is lone pair. So we know that according to VSEPR theory, lone pair bond pair repulsion is greater than the lone pair bond pair repulsion, which is greater than two bond pairs. As a result, due to the presence of this lone pair, there is a distorted shape for this. For example, for this type of molecule is SF4, and it has distorted pentagonal bipyramidal, or you can say it is seesaw structure. Then B part, hydrogen fluoride is liquid while hydrogen chloride is gas. Why? We know that the physical state of compounds depends on two factors. One is their molecular mass, and second one is their intermolecular force. So here, based on the molecular mass, HCl has more molecular mass than HF, but HF is a liquid and HCl is a gas. Reason, HF, due to the high polarity of their bond and the positive charge is present in hydrogen and the negative charge in fluorine, so it can form hydrogen bond. Due to the hydrogen bond, the molecules are more closer than compared to HCl. It can form only dipole-dipole interaction. As a result of hydrogen bond, HF exists in liquid state, and HCl, due to the absence of hydrogen bond, it exists in gaseous state. Question number 16. The threshold frequency for a metal is given, that is 7 × 10⁴ second inverse. Calculate the kinetic energy of the electron emit when radiation of frequency nu is 1 × 10⁵ second inverse hits the metal. We know that kinetic energy, the equation for calculating kinetic energy is equal to h into nu minus nu zero, where h is a Planck's constant and nu is the frequency of radiation used, and nu zero is the threshold frequency. So when we calculate, that is a value of h is 6.626 × 10⁴, and we'll minus 1 × 10⁵ minus, then we had to convert the 10⁴ into 15, because if both are same unit, we can easily subtract that. So we'll get the answer is 1.99 × 10⁻¹⁹. So you have to double check all the calculations. Okay. Then we'll go to the next slide. 17. Write the IUPAC name of the following compounds. Two compounds are given and their structure. 3-ethyl-4-methyl hexane, and second one, we can either write 5-ketoheptanoic acid or 5-oxoheptanoic acid. Question number 18. The standard enthalpies of formation of CH4, CO2 and H2 are given. The values are given. Calculate the standard enthalpy of the reaction. So we know that the enthalpy change of the reaction will be the standard. So I didn't represent the zero. That's difficult. So you can just read like that. Enthalpy change of reaction is equal to enthalpy change of formation of products minus enthalpy of formation of reactants. So when we substitute these values, we'll get the answer. Question number 19. Account for the following. Ionic radius of fluoride is 136 picometer, but that of fluorine is only 64. Then question, the second part of that, second ionization enthalpy of all the elements is always greater than that of the first ionization enthalpy. There is a typing mistake. Okay, first one, the reason, we know that while adding one electron to fluorine atom, there is no change in the shell, so size should be remains constant, but here there is a large difference in the size, that is, there is a large increase in the size. The reason is that fluorine is a very small atom. The extra electron, that is the eighth electron of that shell, go to the 2p subshell. So second shell is a very small shell, so it cannot accommodate all that 8 electrons. So there is an electron-electron repulsion between incoming electron and existing electrons. Due to this repulsion, its size increases. Then second part, we know that after removing an electron from an atom, it will form a positive ion. Positive ions has more nuclear charge than the parent atom because of the decrease in number of electrons. So the effective nuclear charge will be more in cations. As a result, the valence shell experiences more nuclear charge and there is a shrink in size. That's atomic size of the cation is always smaller. So if you want to remove one more electron from that cation, we need to supply more energy to break that attractive force. So that's why the second ionization enthalpy is always higher. But there is an exception. There is so many exceptions in the case of we can explain in the based on the electronic configuration, like second group elements and 16th group elements. So that we already discussed in our chapters. Question number 20. Give the Lewis concepts of acids and bases with suitable example. According to Lewis, acids will accept one pair of electron, they will accept pair of electron. Bases will donate pair of electrons. As example, all electron deficient compounds of group 2, group 3, all these are ready to accept pair of electrons because of completing their octet. So all these are considered as Lewis acids. And all the molecules which contain lone pair of electrons are ready to give one pair of electrons and they are act as Lewis bases. Question number 21. Differentiate between classical smog and photochemical smog. Suggest any two methods to control photochemical smog. So the main difference between classical smog and photochemical smog is, in classical smog, the major constituent is due to the presence of sulfur dioxide and some other products formed by the combustion of fuels. In photochemical smog, the main reason is due to the presence of nitrogen dioxide, NO2, and other products formed by the combustion produced from factories, automobiles, etc. And the first one, classical smog is reducing in nature. We know that SO2 will easily convert to SO3 by accepting oxygen. So it is reducing in nature. But the photochemical smog is oxidizing in nature. Then classical smog occurs in cold and humid places. Then photochemical smog, the just opposite is warm, dry, hot climate. Then the first one will cause irritation, bronchitis, lung problem, etc. And second also almost same, it is cause irritation in eyes. Then we can control the formation of photochemical smog by controlling the formation of their components like NO2, hydrocarbons, ozone, etc. So in automobiles, we can use the catalytic converter which prevents the release of NO2 and hydrocarbons out to the environment. Then growing certain plants like Pinus, juniperus, vitis, etc. They can metabolize the presence of NO2, so that as a result, the amount of NO2 in the environment will decrease. So there are so many examples you can write by using bicycle instead of cars, growing more trees, like that you can write any example. Question number 22. Lithium shows some properties which are different properties, which are different reason from other alkali metals. So there is extra period is there, sorry, give reason. And second is match the following. So we know that lithium is different from other group members, like all the first members of the all groups, due to their small size, high charge density and high charge by mass ratio, etc. Then match the following. Let's see. Already baking soda, antiseptic or for skin infection, caustic soda, purification of bauxite, plaster of Paris, dentistry, limestone. It's used in toothpaste. We can know. There are some uses we can interchange, then even then it is correct. So I wrote only one correct option. There are so many correct options are available. 23. Pb plus PbO2 plus 2H2SO4 for giving PbSO4 plus 2H2. Identify the following. The substance oxidized, substance reduced, oxidizing agent, reducing agent. And second part, what is disproportionation reaction? So this is a reaction that happens in lead storage battery. The substance oxidizes Pb. Pb is converted into PbSO4. So the oxidation state increases from 0 to plus 2. So the substance reduced is PbO2. In PbO2, the oxidation state of Pb is plus 4. It is converted into PbSO4, that is decreased to plus 2. So if the substance oxidized will be the reducing agent and substance reduced will be the oxidizing agent. Then disproportionation reaction means in the same reaction simultaneously same element undergo both oxidation and reduction. That is called disproportionation reaction. We can write so many examples. A very good example is decomposition of hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen. In this, in H2O2, oxygen has minus one oxidation state. Then it is converted to when we come to the product. In water, oxygen has minus two oxidation state. So that decreases from minus one to minus two. Then that means it undergo reduction. The second O2, the oxidation state is 0. That is minus 1 to 0. That means increase. That means oxidation. So it undergo both oxidation and reductions oxygen. So it is an example for disproportionation reaction. Draw the molecular orbital diagram of F2 molecule and predict its magnetic properties. So I copied the structure from some other Google site, so it's not clear because it is very difficult to draw this structure using the, I'm not expert in drawing in laptop, excuse about that. So in this structure, when we can see that there is only paired electrons in this. So it is diamagnetic. Question number 25. Calculate the mass of SO3 produced when 500 gram of SO2 react with 200 gram of O2 according to the reaction. So according to the reaction, 2 mole of SO2 react with 1 mole of O2 giving 2SO3. So we can convert the whole mass into moles. So 500 gram of SO2 is equal to 500 divided by 64. 64 is a molecular mass, is it right? 32 plus 60, yeah, it's right. So 500 plus 64 is equal to 7.8125 mole. Then 200 gram of O2 is 200 by molecular mass of oxygen, that is 32. We will get 6.25 mole. So we need twice the amount of SO2 than O2. So there is 6.25 mole of oxygen. So we need 12.5 50 mole of SO2, but that much amount of SO2 is not available. So SO2 is the limiting reactant. So limiting reactant decides the amount of products formed. So we can take, we have only 7.8125 mole of SO2, and half of that, that is 2 mole, here 1 mole. So 7.8125, half of that is 3.9065 mole of O2 gives the same amount, that is 7.8125 mole of SO3. So we are converting that mole into gram by using the molecular mass of SO3, that is 16 into 3 is 48 plus 32. Yeah, it's 80. So we'll get a 625 gram of SO3. The limiting reactant is a reactant which is completely consumed. In this case, SO2 is completely consumed. So it is a limiting reactant. Question number 36. Briefly describe the following with suitable chemical equations. Wood's reaction, Kraft-Shaft. I think there is no need of explanation because it is very easy. So two alkyl halides react with the sodium metal in dry ether to form higher alkene, that is called the Wood's reaction. Then crash effect is just opposite of Markovnikov's rule. It happens when unsymmetric alkene react with unsymmetric addendum, especially only the HBr in presence of organic peroxide. We'll get the product which is just opposite that of Markovnikov's rule, that is the negative part of the addendum will go to the carbon which contain more number of hydrogen, that is called crash effect. Question number 27. If the concentration of hydrogen ion in soft drink is 3 into 10 raised to minus 3, calculate the pH. Then second part, an aqueous solution of NaCl is neutral while that of CuCl2 is acidic. Why? So first we can calculate the pH by using the negative logarithm of concentration of H plus. The calculation is given. Then second part, we know that NaCl is a salt of strong acid and strong base. Strong acid and strong base in solution always exist as ions. So in products, there will be Na plus Cl minus ions and H plus and OH minus. The concentration of H plus and OH minus will be equal because they are completely ionized. Both will completely ionized. As a result, it will be neutral. All the solutions of strong acid and bases will be, salt of strong acid and bases will be neutral. We already discussed that in our video. If you have any doubt, you can go back to that video and check it. Then in CuCl2, on hydrolysis, we know that it will form a weak base and strong acid. So weak base, it may be undergo dissociation but not completely dissociated. So we are writing that by undissociate. We know that we don't know the how much it is dissociated, but HCl is dissociated 100%. So the concentration of H plus is always greater than that of OH minus. So the solution will be acidic. Question number 28. State Dalton's law of partial pressures, and the second part is calculate the total pressure. Using that, you can calculate the total pressure of a mixture of gases. So Dalton pressure, you know the statement, and if the total pressure of a non-reacting gases will the sum of their individual pressures. So we have to convert the number of gram into moles first. So 8 gram of oxygen into 0.25 gram, and that of 4 gram of hydrogen into 4/2 mole. Then use the equation P is equal to N1 plus N2. N1 and N2 are the number of moles of oxygen and hydrogen, and divided by V into RT. Here the volume is given in, it is 1 decimeter, so I use the value 1. And we'll get the answer. Check the answer twice. Question number 29. Substantiate the amphoteric nature of water with the chemical equation. Then second part, what is mean by 100 volume of H2O2? We know that water is amphoteric because it can act as both acid and base by accepting H plus and donating H plus. The examples are given. When it reacts with ammonia, a base, it acts as an acid by giving its H plus ions to ammonia. And the second example, when it reacts with HCl, it will accept the 1H plus ion and form hydronium ion. So it is act as a base. Then The strength of hydrogen peroxide always says like how much amount of oxygen it will liberate on decomposition. So 100 volume of H2O2 means 1 liter of H2O2 will give 100 ml of O2 at STP. Question number 30. What are the important observations and conclusions made by Rutherford experiment, alpha ray scattering experiment? Give two limitations. Okay. We know that most of the alpha particles passed through the atom. It is like that. Straight through the gold foil. Some of the alpha particles were deflected by small angles. A few particles were deflected by large angles, and about a very, very, very few is reflected at large angles. That means 180 degree, it retraces its path back, or it is rebound. So based on this observation, we can reach the conclusion most of the space in an atom is empty because most of the rays passed through the atom without undergoing any deflection. Second, atom contains a positive massive center. So some of the atoms are deflected back, so there should be a positive, because alpha particles are positive charge and it is massive, so it can deflected only by a positive massive center. Then volume of the positive center is very small compared to the total atom because only very few undergo deflection. Then its failure is failed to explain the stability of atom, and it doesn't explain the electronic structure, etc. Question number 31. Write a short note on fullerenes and silicates. So I'm not reading that. You can just read. Question number 32. What is spontaneous process? And for a reaction is given, entropy is negative 549.4. At 298 Kelvin, in spite of the negative entropy change, why the reaction is spontaneous? So we know that even though the entropy is negative, the reaction will be spontaneous because the condition for spontaneity is the delta G, that is a change in free energy, must be negative, because free energy is the energy available for a system to do useful work. If a system do work by itself, that is called spontaneous process, its energy, free energy, always increases. So we can prove that by using the calculation delta G is equal to delta S minus T delta zero. So when we calculate, we will get the negative value for delta G zero. So if delta G is negative, the reaction will be spontaneous. Question number 33. Arrange the following carbocations in the increasing order of stability and justify your answer on the basis of hyperconjugation. And second part of that is define homolytic fission. So we know that if there is positive or negative charge concentrated on particular atom, that will be unstable because some of the fragments or ions will attack at that center. So we can say that it is unstable. So when the amount of positive, here it is carbocation, so the carbon carries positive charge. So if the positive charge decreases, or if there is a reason for resonating that positive charge or delocalizing the positive charge, that will be more stable. So hyperconjugation effect, we know that the sigma bonded electrons of CH bond or CC bond get involved with the pi electron or p pi bonds. So in the the third one, that is tertiary butyl carbonium ion, that is the carbonyl carbon, that is carbon with the positive charge, is attached to 3CH3 group. Each 3CH3 has 3CH bonds, so there is a total of 9 CH bonds. So there is 9 resonance structure possible, or we can say that there is 9 CH bonds which can separately give electrons to that carbonium ion. So that is a most stable one. Then the next one will be the dimethyl, that is isopropyl carbonium ion. It has 6 CH bonds. Then the less stable will be ethyl carbonium ion. It has only 3, and the least stable will be CH3 plus, because it doesn't have any CH group is attached to the carbonyl carbon. Hence the stability is in the order. Less stable will be CH3 plus, then CH3, CH2 plus, then comes CH3 twice, CH plus, and the last one will be CH3 thrice, C plus. That stability increases with the increase in number of CH bonds attached to the carbonyl carbon. Then homolytic break, homolytic fission is a simple fission, that is a covalent bond is, after breaking the covalent bond, each atom will get its own electron. As a result, free radicals are produced. And usually, non-polar covalent bonds undergo homolytic fission. An example is given. So that's all for this video. So there may be question number mistake or spelling mistake or calculation mistake, any type of mistake. So please excuses about that, because I don't get time to recheck all these slides back and forth again and again. It will take so much time. So thank you for watching my video. Thank you. Bye bye.